What's up guys, welcome to a new Revit tutorial. Today I am going to calculate rebar weights in Revit. I am going to use a Revit schedule which I prepared in my other video. You can find that video from the first link in the description. Before I move any further, I ask you to please subscribe to my channel and like this video because it helps me out a lot. We can find the rebar weight using two different approaches. First approach is the product of total rebar length and weight per unit length. This is the simplest and most common approach and also a very easy for beginners. So I decided to explain it in this video. Second approach is a bit complicated to apply in Revit. It is a product of rebar volume and rebar density. So I decided to make a separate video for this approach in the future. Without any further delay, let's move on to Revit. I am going to add some fields or column in my existing schedule. In the select field box, I won't choose any of the available fields. Instead of that, I will make a new parameter. And for the parameter name, I will write unit weight. For the discipline, I will select structural. And for the type of parameter, I will select mass per unit length and then click OK. So we have unit weight in schedule fields. Now I will click on add calculated parameter button. For the name, let's call it total weight. And for the discipline, I will use structural. And for the type, I will select mass. Now I will make a formula for this field. I will click on three dotted button, will show the schedule fields. So I will select total bar length and then click OK. Then type a multiplication sign and again click on the button and select unit weight and click OK. And our formula is complete. Now close the box. Let's drag the image field to the bottom and click OK. So we have two new fields added. You can see these two fields added in the sheets also. Now I will do some text alignment and add the unit weights for each diameter of bar. And you can see it calculates the weight of that bar. We can change rounding and remove mm sign from the unit weight values. So I go to unit, structural units and find mass per unit length. Then change the rounding to 3 decimal places and symbol to none. Then click OK. We can add the symbol to the heading of cell. Next I am going to add the grand totals in my schedule. I will click on edit fields in the properties and in the schedule properties I will open sorting and grouping. Then check the grand totals. Then I will go to formatting tab. Select the total weight from the fields and select calculate total and then click on OK. We have the calculated grand totals in the schedule. We can resize the columns as per our need. Then view the sheet and you can see rebar weights calculated in the schedule. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please like, comment and share this video. But make sure you subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching this video. See you in the next one.